I think the most common mistake in creating a provisional patent application for a new inventor is under inclusion. You have to think of the document as a word bank, and you've got to have all the words in there that you're ever going to want to claim down the road.
The most common mistakes I see in provisional filings are not describing the invention in enough technical detail. Really, a provisional is only as good as it enables someone to make and use the technology, because that's the threshold that the patent office is going to be looking at for whether or not this can serve as a priority document. So you want to describe the invention in enough detail and in enough variations so that you get a little broader protection, but that you're digging deep in your kind of depth of description.
If you invented the pen with blue ink, you don't want a pen with blue ink. You want a pen that, with any kind of ink, or a writing implement with any kind of writing modality. So you have to think at the early stage of writing the patent, not just what is my invention, but what will it compete with, and what alternatives to it would I be offended if I saw them come into my competitive marketplace. And the patent has to be created with that in mind, so that you can create a barrier around a competitive marketplace, not merely protect your invention. One thing you can do today with provisional practice is you can file multiple provisionals. You can refile it once a week or once a month or once a quarter, adding in additional things that you've thought of after you filed it. So there is some good news that you can evolve the document as you go through time, but make sure that you disclose the invention as fully as you possibly can.